Right. Here we go.
Alright, so there's actually a trophy for looking in most of the display cases. All you have to do is, like, you know, walk near them and press the up arrow, or of course the up directional button as it's actually called, not the arrow. What the hell am I talking about? Must be on some sort of bad cocaine. Anyway, you gotta look at these, like, little, like, what are they called? The displays, I guess you'd call them. Yeah, I guess you look at the displays and get a trophy for it. However, of course, I already have them all, so I won't be getting any right here. Although I do know there's a treasure in there, and that it looks like some sort of ring. Possibly, is that jade? Jade ring, maybe? Jade diamond ring? Looks like it anyway. I don't know the names of the treasures, and I'm probably not going to be looking at them, and I'm probably not going to be trying to collect them. Of course, if I know where they are, I'll just go for them, but there's quite a few that I don't know where they are, of course, because it's kind of hard to try and remember where 101 treasures actually are in a game this big. I actually can finish this game very quickly. I think I beat it in like 5 hours before, which is very quick for an Uncharted game, probably less than that actually. But obviously, like I say, I'm going to try and make it a bit more cinematic and try and go through it a bit more slowly, a bit more like procedurally, try and like follow the cutscenes and follow the story, try and let you hear what's going on rather than me like flying through, because usually I just like sprint through the entire game and, you know, try and beat it, try and like beat a personal best time or something. What we actually want is this little thing here, this little display case here, because that is where we need to be. However, I'm sniffing a treasure. Am I sniffing a treasure, or am I just completely wrong? I think that might be later down the line, because I do know we have to come back here. Actually, no, the treasure is over here, right? This guy's got it, I think. This guy has the treasure? No, I think that's actually later on. They put one in that guy's hands or something. Yeah, you can actually use the steering wheel here. That's the steering wheel. Sailing wheel, I guess it's called. The ship's wheel, whatever. You can actually use that. Doesn't do anything. I guess it's just there for show. Of course, like everything is. Let's just look at the display case, shall we?
Here it is. Ah, crap.
¡Ratita callejera!
¡Suélteme!
Su clase de gente no es bienvenida aquí. ¡Quédate afuera!
¡Pendejo!
So now all we have to do is tail young Sully. Young Sully is like such a like handsome guy. I mean, he's handsome already. You know, he's handsome as like the silver fox, you know what I mean? But when he's younger, I don't know. There's just something about the guy. And I'm not gay, but I'll say this for sure. Sully. I'd get with Sully. You know what I'm saying? Sully's a nice guy. Anyway, what we're going to do here, this introduces you to like the stealth aspects of the game. You can like hide against this policia car like this. Just, oh yeah, like that. Crouch down. Of course, this is in every Uncharted game. And you can like slide across the gap like that. Ooh, hit these, what are these? Like mangoes maybe? I'm not exactly sure. Of course, I'm probably going to get these fruits wrong. Then again, I'm sure the fruits weren't actually considered, like, you know, all these are very, like, high detail, high resolution fruits, because, of course, you only see them a few times throughout the game, so who would ever care about, like, making these perfect?
Don't mind if I do.
Vete de aquí, limonero!
It was rotten anyway.
Did the sound just skip there for a second? I don't know, it kind of sounded like it skipped there. That might have been just for me, though. I hope so. Anyway, there are a few treasures around here, I do believe. Of course, you have to tail Sully, but I know where he's going anyway, so this shouldn't be a problem. I don't think there's actually one down here. Of course, you can just look for the glimmer, the gateway to glimmer. You can look for the glimmer, and the glimmer will show you where the treasures are. Like I say, I'm not going to be going for them. So, if you're looking for a treasure guide, this is not the place to be. However, I'm smelling the treasures. I'm, like, really smelling one. There must be one nearby. I think it's in a rack or something. Here's one. Some sort of vase, cup, whatever this thing is. And I know there's actually, like, a doll or something. Why did the camera just shift there? No idea. Yeah, the camera can just shift randomly at some points because it's actually trying to, like, show you some sort of story element or something like that. There's also places where you can press up, which, of course, puts you into this little cinematic view. And that'll also show you, like, some things that Nate's looking at, and that'll also, like, comment on that stuff. Is there something over here? You know, I feel that there is. There's something down here for sure, I know that. Okay, I think it's actually up in this little area here. Let's just check real quick. Yes, there it is. That's some little doll or something. Nate, can you move? Thank you very much. Don't know why, but it got stuck there. That looks very creepy. I don't think I would want that. Anyway, there's a few more like treasures around here, but obviously, like I say, I don't really want to slow down the game too much by going to collect them all. So it's really weird how there's like pig heads everywhere. I know this is like the done thing, but seriously, there's flies and shit. Come on, clean that up. My god. Anyway, what we're gonna do? My god, stuttering here and not being able to speak coherently. My god. Okay, so gotta do. Oh my god, I did it again. What we're gonna do is tail Sully and follow him. Basically, he's going to a locksmith and he's gonna get that key. That key that he used, I believe, was one of those like wax keys that you get. Although it did shine a bit. And then again, it could have been wet wax, of course. Maybe it needed to be wet. No idea what happened. But I think it might have been one of those wax keys where you put the key into the hole and it matches the pins and the grooves and stuff. It matches the pins and all that stuff like that. I just completely messed up my words there. Whatever, you get what I'm trying to say. It matches those, and then the locksmith's like, okay, yeah, I'll cut the key in the correct way. I explained that so badly, I'm sure. Anyway, Nate, can you fucking do what I want you to do? Christ, you can't actually like go left. What the hell, Nate? Jump, you fuck! There we go. Christ, you see him jumping up like that and not actually grabbing it. Sometimes that just happens. It's very annoying. I might actually need to turn my fan on so some background noise may ensue. Because I'm actually sweating like a pig right now.
Aquí lo tiene.
That's a ticket. Gracias. Adios, amigo.
Okay. I gotta get that wallet. Crap. I can't go down that way.
Now, as far as I know, there are actually two more treasures around here. I think I've actually missed one already, but like I say, it's not about the treasures. But, you know, when I feel like I can get one, I'm going to try and get one. Of course, this over here, what is it? Some sort of weird mask with no eye holes, so I guess it's just some sort of weird ornament. You can actually do this a different way. I like to do this, like this, what I'm doing right now. But you can climb up and, like, shimmy along. However, I feel this is actually a faster way. As you can see right now, he's doing a little shimmy. You can do that all the way, but it's very slow. And yeah, I do know some like, you know, quick tricks to do like that kind of thing. I don't like to play this game too slow because yeah, it can take a very long time. There's actually a dagger over here, I believe. Is there a dagger? I think it's like in the O in the hotel. Oh, there it is. Look, see that? Got the dagger. There we go. Some sort of, it looks more like a fucking butter knife to me. I guess it is. It's a dagger though, right? No, it must be a knife because there's no way that can be a dagger. That is not dagging into anything. Of course, it did tell me to look up there, but I was already in a downward movement. So, yeah, that's not happening. Anyway, I think he was just mentioning that Sully is actually with someone right now. He's actually with Marlo, as you can see over there. She's looking almost exactly the same. Same hairstyle and everything.
Damn it. Don't want to go down there.
So now all we have to do is walk up behind Sully and try and pickpocket him. Of course, this is before Nate and Sully were besties, so the situation was a little bit different back then.
Okay, it's right there in his pocket. Now's my chance.
It seems we have some time to kill.
I got an idea how we can while away a few hours.
vuélteme viejo!
Let's try that again.
Let go of me.
Ah, that's what I thought. Now don't try to run. You're a long way from home, son.
Don't call me that.
Parents must be worried about you.
Yeah, not likely.
Okay, sore subject. That was a nice lift back there. You're pretty good.
I don't know what you're talking about, old man.
Hey, don't call me that. Your technique is really sloppy, though. You're telegraphing all your moves.
You're crazy.
Yeah? You've been tailing me all over town. Probably figured me for an easy mark. But you picked the wrong guy, pal.
What?
My wallet. Fine. Maybe we'll just call the police.
Go ahead. Of course, they might wonder why a middle-aged tourist is following young boys down alleyways.
You are a crafty little beggar, aren't you?
I know how to take care of myself. Anyway, I'm pretty sure you don't like the cops any more than I do.
Good point. Kid. The wallet.
Had to try.
Of course you did.
Telegraphing all my moves, huh? Museum's closed.
So, Nate sure is a crafty little beggar, isn't he? Anyway, what we're going to do now is shimmy along the rope and try and get into the museum. There's actually an open window we're going to go through, but before we do that, we're actually going to drop down to the lower balcony, because the treasure down there. I mean, come on, I don't know what it is. Something about collecting shit in games, it just gets to me. And like I say, I have beat this game 100%, which means I have gone through and collected all the trophies and all the treasures. Some of the trophies in this game are freaking ridiculous, though. It's like, get 50 billion kills a sniper rifle. There's only a few situations where you ever get one. It's like, what the fuck, man? Anyway, what we're going to do, I keep messing that like line up. What we're going to do, I can't say that for some reason. This is where Nate wasn't particularly amazing at like climbing and shit, but he's still pretty good. He's probably better than most kids. But anyway, down here, I believe there's a doge. Is there a doge? Is it down here? Oh, please don't tell me I've forgotten. Oh, there's something over here. Oh, I can still do a roll. Nice. Is it a doge? I guess you could call it a doge with a cock on its arse. I have no words. I have no words at all. Well, there you go. Anyway, what we're going to do is go back up here. Can we actually, like, jump backwards, please? Can we not do this? I'm sure I've done that before, but oh well. We'll try a different method up. I think we can actually climb down here like this, and then climb up this little, what would this be called? Well, this is a pipe, of course, it's a drainage pipe. What's this little bit called here? The little mesh. That has a name, I'm sure. I can't really recall right now. Maybe I'll Google it, if I feel so inclined as to do that. Anyway, they put an actual treasure in this guy's hands, look! I don't know why they would ever do that, but they did! So weird, it's some sort of a head. Nice. I believe there's also another treasure in here. Is there not? I'm smelling it. Ah, there it is. Of course, it's a coin with a Templar emblem on it. Nice.
Whoa.
Damn it, kid.
Why, Victor, look who it is. The filthy little stray that made off with your wallet.
on, son. You haven't got a chance. Just hand it over.
Now, the ring.
What ring?
Catherine!
Who do you think you are, boy? You're nothing but a filthy, cast-off little beggar. You're not fit to touch these objects.
What the hell do you think you're doing? He's just a kid.
Stop him!
Stop the boy!
Okay, so now you have to run for our life, which can be quite tricky, because you kind of have to know what you're doing. If you don't, then you will get caught. Now this one is actually like horrified me, because sometimes Nate just refuses to grab hold of that thing, and I have no idea why. He'll just jump up against the wall and be an absolute dick about it. Very annoying. Now here we're actually going to get grabbed by a guy. We'll have to like mash a button. Of course, it's square. Brilliant. You don't have to mash this hard, but I do anyway. I mash incredibly hard. I don't know what it is. I just have the feeling that I'm going to get absolutely slaughtered if I don't like mash for my life. It actually feels like I need to do it. Otherwise, I'm going to die, because actually I will. Shit, I just dropped off the edge there. That's not what I intended to do, but you know, it happened. There's actually a point later on in the game, which I'm probably going to die on a lot, because it doesn't give you any indication of what button to press. And you have to mash incredibly hard, otherwise you'll drown. Which, kind of a bit of a spoiler there, but you know, it's okay, it's okay, it's fine. Anyway, crushing mode hasn't actually become an actual thing just yet. Of course, we're in crushing mode, we're actually on crushing mode. I don't know how many times I said that there, probably about 7. We're actually on that now, so it's very difficult. However, platforming and like a little bit of fighting and stuff, that doesn't actually like come into play when it comes to crushing. What comes into play is when people start shooting at you and when you have to shoot them, and when there's a few goonies to fight. That's when crushing comes into play, because of course you can only take a few bullets and then you die. I'm trying, Sully. My god, thanks for helping though. It's really appreciated. Sully is an absolute fucking badass. He is brilliant, helps you out. I think it's because he sees the potential in Nate. Of course, they'll introduce themselves officially later on. Anyway, we've got to jump over here and we've got to press X at the right moment. I think you just smash it. Okay, you can slam this into the guy's head like that, of course. I tried to do it. Sometimes that won't happen. You have to actually go around this. I try jumping over it. Sometimes it doesn't work. Of course, jump over the bed and jump out the window. There we go. That's cinematic as all hell. Anyway, sometimes that won't work. I've played this game enough times to know that sometimes it can happen where you'll just get like caught on something. You have to. I don't know if you have to do this, but I like to jump here because I feel that I'm going to go through that. Although I think the glass actually smashes a little too far behind to actually make a difference here. But then again, I just feel like I'm in danger. Anyway, cutscene!
Look what we have here. Whoops. You all right? What are you shaking for? Just close your eyes. This won't hurt a bit. Come on. You're okay, kid. Relax, kid. We're safe here. Go on. Suit yourself. You don't want it.
What do you want from me?
A little gratitude would be nice. I did just save your ass back there.
Thanks. But what's in it for you? I mean, you're a crook, right? You gotta have an angle.
You are one piece of work, kid. What's your story, anyway?
Look, mister. No offense, but I don't even know you.
Easily remedied. Victor Sullivan. This would be the part where you introduce yourself. Okay. Suppose you tell me what's so special about that ring.
It belongs in my family. I'm just taking it back.
Passed down from Francis Drake himself.
That's right.
I don't know how to break this to you, kid, but Drake didn't have any heirs. No children.
Well, not with his wife back in England, anyway.
Okay, good point. Let me see it. Come on, kid. If I was gonna take it from you, I would have done it by now. Thank you. So, what is this?
Sic Parvis Magna. It means greatness from small beginnings. That was his motto.
Yeah?
You see, Queen Elizabeth gave it to him in 1581, when he got back to England after circumnavigating the globe. That's when she made him a knight.
Well, you sure as hell didn't learn that on the streets. How's a kid your age know Latin?
The nuns sort of insisted on it.
So, like a boarding school?
That's a nice word for it.
Okay, then. So what was all that business with the ring and that astrolabe thing back there?
Why don't you tell me? You're the one working for him.
Look, kid. A client wants something, I obtain it. For a price. I don't ask any questions. It's just a job.
Look pretty friendly to me.
Yeah, well. Anyway, I'm pretty sure I'm fired.
Okay, look. First of all, that was no astrolabe. It's some sort of decoding device. Check this out. On his way around the world, Drake sailed through the East Indies. Only he says that it took him 6 months to get from here to here.
Yeah, so?
So it doesn't add up. He was way too good a sailor for that. It would have taken him a month, tops. He was hiding something. Something big.
How big?
Like secret mission from the Queen big. Like millions in plundered treasure that hasn't ever been recovered big.
That big?
That big.
And that decoder has something to do with it.
I would bet my life on it.
Oh, swell. And Marlowe's got it.
Won't do her much good without the key.
So it's a stalemate, then?
For now.
So you still haven't told me what your name is?
And you still haven't told me what you want from me.
Okay. Look, you got talent, but you got a lot to learn. You stick with me, and I'll teach you a few things.
Thanks. But I'm doing just fine on my own.
Yeah, clearly. What do you say we try this again? My friends call me Sully.
Nathan Drake. Nate.
Drake, huh? Okay. I see great things in our future, kid. Great things.